I've been an artist all my life. I had a company called Mies Mouse, and I was the owner of this company, and I designed and manufactured, well, I guess accessories for little girls, headbands, hair bows, tutus, wands, purses, shoes. Well, we ended up with about 250 different products in my company. 11 years ago, my daughter and I and two other friends were driving up to Lake Tahoe for a vacation in July of 1997, and we were just driving along 101, minding our own business, and it was sunny and warm and beautiful, and no one had been drinking. It wasn't a driving drinking accident, and just out of the blue, somebody came and crashed into the side of our SUV and caused our, we were in a Toyota Land Cruiser, and it just rolled over, kind of twisted and spun out of control and rolled over three times. And every time it rolled over, the roof came down on my head and caused my neck to break in three places, and split my head open, front part to the back and around my ear. And I had 76 stitches in my head. And I was in a road arrest bed for about 10 days, and then was taken up to San Francisco and had surgery on my neck, and then brought back to Santa Clara Valley Medical Center, where I was there for 3 months. And for the first 2 months, I couldn't talk or eat or breathe or pretty much do anything but just blink my eyes to communicate. This piece here, it started as a collage on my wall in my bedroom. Many people sent me cards and prayer cards and little posters, and there's a piece there that's sort of a sequin Lady of Guadalupe that a friend of mine bought back from Mexico for me. And I started collecting them on my bedroom wall, and they've been up there for maybe 2 years, I guess. And they were getting dusty and a little bit, you know, not very nice looking. And so I decided that I'd take them off the wall, put them on a board just so that I could keep them. And as I was putting them on the board, I started realizing that maybe I could, you know, make it into a collage and an actual piece of art. So I had a caregiver that worked with me, and we put it all together. And then I decided to frame it because it looks so beautiful. And that became my first collage. I've been really, really fortunate to find caregivers that like the art, enjoy doing, you know, different things. And for instance, I have one lady that really enjoys cutting out the stones, and she does nothing but just cut stones out for me. At nighttime when she's working my, doing the night shift, she'll cut stones for me. And then I have another lady that really enjoys cutting out the paper images, so she'll just cut out the paper images for me. And then I have another young girl actually that I've hired that works a couple of days a week for me, and she'll come and paint, do actually whatever, you know, I need to have done, but she's mostly does the painting. And it always changes too, because my caregivers come and go. So when my caregivers go, then I have to get new caregivers, and hopefully I find some that enjoy doing artwork, or I have to wait a little while till I find the right person. If my daughter's in town, then she'll help me also with helping, you know, put glue stones on, or, you know, cut things out for me, or whatever I need to have done. This is one of my first three-dimensional collage pieces that I created. I made an altar out of it for the Steinbeck Museum. Again, they were having a Dia de los Muertos exhibit, and so I created this. It was an altar for friends and family that have passed away. What I did was we painted the legs. We created a little, sort of a little cemetery on the seat of it. And then there's little pictures on the back of the chair and then all along the sides. And those are of my my grandparents, my aunts, uncles, friends of ours that have passed away, my father, my uncle. Also, along the front here, there's these little stones that we make for lots of my different pieces of art that I make. We've taken these little glass stones and we put images behind them. I'll pick out an image, let's say, of a saint or maybe a Dia de los Muertos, an image that I really love, and then we reduce it down through my color copying machine that I have. And then we actually glue the stone onto it, let it set up dry, and then I have one of my caregivers cut them out. And then we glue those on. Then we also made little miniature papel picado around the edge of the seat here, around the bottom of the chair. And then underneath the chair on the bottom is a whole nother collage of the Lady of Guadalupe and different saints and icons that I like. And so what you do is you look into the mirror on the bottom of the chair here, and then you can look up and you can see the collage underneath. I've done actually some collages for some families. Well, they'll give me pictures of their children, and then we'll talk about what images that they like, and then we'll create a whole collage for them. Dia de los Muertos. It's a celebration that the Latin community celebrates on November the 2nd, and it's a day that they celebrate the people in their family or friends that have passed on, and they'll build an altar in their home or actually go and decorate the gravesite of the person that has passed on, and they'll bring the special food, and or maybe let's say if it's a child, they'll bring little toys, and they'll do offerings for the person that has passed away. I love her. I think she's so gorgeous. Simone was also done for a Dia de los Muertos exhibit at the Pajaro Valley Art Gallery, and the show was called La Mujer, which was the woman. And so every single image on this mannequin is of a woman, and it's of the Latina woman in many different doing many different things, whether she's holding a child or she's dancing or she's cooking or she's doing something in the home, or all the saints on this one are women. There's not any men saints on this collage. It's so tedious and so time consuming and so detail oriented, and I was a person that did everything really fast, and I wanted to get it done, and I wanted to, you know, just get on to the next thing, whatever it was. Sasha is a little girl that we decided to do. She was my last collage that I did for the Steinbeck show this year. And I wanted to do a little girl, and I wanted to do something kind of whimsical. And we found her from a company in New York that sells used mannequins. And she's from the 1940s. She's a very old mannequin. And her little face, you know, she just looks like she's alive. And her little eyes are so sparkly and so beautiful. And I wanted to do something with sort of vintage Mother Goose images. And a very good friend of mine had a very old Mother Goose book from the 1920s. And that's what we did with most of these images here. They're old Mother Goose stories. And we have like a rabbit. In fact, the rabbit was just running. And then we got from another book, another sort of a children's fairy tale book, we found a little bowl of goldfish. So we put the rabbit holding the goldfish and running. So we'll take images from different books and put them together so that they become a new picture. Everything just worked perfect. I'm just so lucky when it just seems like everything just kind of comes together when we make this. It's almost like magic, really, because, you know, I'll think about, gosh, I really need some little tiny antlers. And a friend of mine will say, gosh, you know, I've got some antlers, and he'll, you know, mail them to me. And these were perfect size, just absolutely perfect. And then we wanted to have I wanted to sort of have as if she was walking through the forest and holding her lantern, you know, sort of guiding her way. And so I made this stick that was sort of her magical lantern. And what she's holding is a very old paper lantern that I had been given years ago. And I just saved it, and it just turned out to be perfect for this.